Hello everyone, welcome to GIS Man. I'm Miles Lee. In last video, we have talked about how to use the AWS Lambda function and the CloudWatch to relay the instant GeoJSON from Open Geospatial Data API into the AWS S3 buckets. So in this video, we are going to talk about how to develop the Customised widgets in ArcGIS Experience Builder to consume this instant GeoJSON. So let's get started. Firstly, I would like to show you how the final product looks like. This is our final widget. The widget is to show the live traffic conditions on certain locations. So what we are going to do is to click on certain locations on the map, and then nearby this location, for example within 5 kilometers, the live traffic camera point will be pop up. For each camera point, when we click on that, we can see the road name and also the photos of the live traffic camera, and it shows the live traffic condition on this location. Okay, so let's get started and do it step by step. In order to consume the GeoJSON on AWS S3, firstly, what we need to do is to create a function which will consume and retrieve the GeoJSON file and then turn it into the GeoJSON layer. So under the runtime, we will create a new file called createLayer, which is a TypeScript. And then we will need the help from a module from ArcGIS API for JavaScript. The module name will be esri layers GeoJSON layer. Okay, and then after this, we will need to export our function. The function name, we just give it like create GeoJSON layer. Okay, and what we need to do is just to return a GeoJSON layer. So we will need to give some attributes, parameters to this object. So firstly, of course, we will need to have our remote GeoJSON file URL. We can get it by just simply clicking that. And this is our HTTP link for the GeoJSON file. Just copy and paste right here. And after that, we will need to give a pop-up template and also the renderer. We will leave it blank right here and we will come back later to define it. And also, we will need to have an output field. The output fields will define what kinds of fields will be used in our application. So currently we explore everything, okay? So what we are going to do is to come back to define our pop-up template and our renderer. Let's take a look at our original complete widget. When we click on that, it will show two things. One is the title and one is the photo. Okay, and then if we take a look on our GeoJSON files structure, we can see that there are 5 attributes in each feature, like the region, title, view, direction, and the link to the live traffic camera's photo. So what we are going to use is the title and the link. So we will need to define a constant template object, And then the title, we will just need to use the title in our GeoJSON features property. And then the content, we will insert the simple HTML tag, the image source to the link, which will be like this one, which will refer to our link. Okay. So after this, we will need to define our vendor. So we just call it simple vendor. The type is the simple type. And the symbol will be an object. We give it a text type. The color will be orange. See? So I have already prepared that. The color code will be this one. And then the test code. I also copy it. The test code will be the shape of the symbol of the label. Okay, so right here the label will be a pinpoint. And this kind of code can be easily checked in ArcGIS API document or on Google. So no problems about that. Size, we give it 21. And family, I can't remember, the name is too long. I just copy and paste it from my notepad. So everything looks good. And now we will need to put it back, put the constant template back to our pop-up template attributes menu. And then we will need to also have our simple render for our render attribute. Okay. Something wrong with it. Yeah, actually in ArcGIS 3.x we can just simply put the object under the renderer attribute, but in ArcGIS 4.x, currently I'm using ArcGIS 4.x, we can't do that. We will need to use the new object creator from ArcGIS API for JavaScript, and then pass the object we define as a parameter into it, and then let it create the object for us and make it as a value of our attribute. So still something wrong, let's quick fix it. Okay, so this time when we import the modules from ArcGIS, no problem at all. So the next step is to go back to our main page. We will need to have two buttons like this. So what we are going to do is under our ReactJS render functions, we will need to define our bottom HTML code. The type would be, I remember, is secondary. And then on click, we will go back later, and currently I just put it now. Okay, and the size will be large, definitely, because it will be stretched to the home framework. And the style in ReactJS under the ArcGIS Experience Builder, the interesting thing is that we can define the style with JavaScript code instead of CSS. So we just give the style like style.widget style. We use the style 2. Okay, and then the name of the button will be star live camera. This is our first button. And the second button will be similar. We give it a secondary style. And then on click functions, currently we just leave it blank. And size similar. And also the style, I just copy and paste because everything is same as the first button. So I just copy and paste, and then the name will be clear live camera, and you just make the second button. So currently when we reflect our front end, wait for a second. You can see that now we have two button. But this button currently has no functions at all because we didn't define our function yet. What we are going to do is to define our function. The first one, we can give it a name show cameras. Okay, and it's not defined, so that we will need to go back to our code area and then write an arrow functions like show cameras equals to an arrow function. And right here we would just need to use the create layer function we defined in our TypeScript, create layer function should be right here. Yeah, we didn't import the modules. We defined this one and import the function, but we will need to import it in our main page. So we import the create layer and require our TypeScript module. So now it should be okay. Create layer dot use the function we just defined before. Then after this, we have the GeoJSON layer, okay? And what we are going to do is to put it into our Gmail map view, map layers collections. To do that, we will need to define the Gmail map view object in our states in the React.js. If you don't know how to do it, please check my very first video that I posted last month, and I illustrate it pretty clearly. Okay, so this is our first function's definition, and then we will need to go back to define our second function. I just call it clean layers. Okay, so similarly, we will need to define the function right here. You need to use an arrow function. And then this one will be much easier because we don't need to use our create GeoJSON layer functions that we defined before. We just need to clean all the things in our map. So we need to use this and remove all. This is an embed function of ArcGIS API for JavaScript, which allow us to remove all layers inside the map. Okay, so everything looks good. Let's refresh our front end and take a look at the results. So we have two buttons. When we click on the first button, it will retrieve all the features from the remote GeoJSON file. Okay. And then when we click on any location, it will show the name of this location and also shows the photo from the live traffic camera. Okay, and we can also clean all the data from this map layer. But this one is not exactly what we want, as which is shown in our formal layer, formal widgets. In our formal widgets, we will need to show only the live camera point surrounds our click position. For example, when we click on this position, it will just show any camera points around 5 kilometers, within 5 kilometers. It will not retrieve all the data from NSW, not like this one. This one, what you can see is to retrieve all the data from NSW. But this one, what you can see is to show only the camera points within a certain distance. So in order to do this, we will need to have a spatial query, which I will talk in next video. I have already prepared the tag right here. I will talk about that in our next video. So if you are interested in this topic, please just follow it. And yeah, hope you like it. Thanks for watching for today, and see you next time. I will talk about how to do the spatial query, and if have time, I will also talk about how to do the attribute query. So thanks for watching, stay tuned, and see you, bye.